This tutorial will explain to you how to start other applications from inside FreeFileSync. When you right-click on a file, FreeFileSync shows a context-sensitive menu, including the option to call external applications. The default entries allow you to navigate to the selected file via Windows Explorer, or to open it with its associated application. Note that you can also access these items directly from the keyboard by pressing the corresponding button on the numeric keypad. The first entry is special and can be started by pressing Enter or by double-clicking with the mouse. Let's add a new entry and integrate WinMerge to compare our text files. Go to Menu, Tools, Options, and in the Customize Context menu area, start by entering a new description. As command line, you need to enter the path of the WinMerge executable, and also the two paths pointing to the files it should compare. Let's first locate the WinMerge executable and copy its path. You see that the path contains space characters, which are generally used to separate multiple command line arguments. In order to treat it as a single entity, you have to protect it with quotation marks. The next two arguments will be the file paths of the items you select in FreeFileSync's main dialog. FreeFileSync forwards this information via the local path or item path macros. For local files on your computer or network shares, there is no difference between the two. However, if you are accessing FTP, SFTP, or MTP devices using FreeFileSync, other Windows applications will not support their non-native paths. The solution is to use the Local Path macro. Local Path instructs FreeFileSync to create a temporary local copy of the file that ordinary Windows applications can access. Again, you need to wrap the arguments in quotes, just in case the resolved path contains a space character. Now, let's make a test. See how the newly integrated application has been added to the context menu and automatically been assigned a number as a keyboard shortcut. And it opens just as we wanted it. This even works when multiple items have been selected. For more information and a few ready-to-use examples, go to the Options dialog and click on Show Examples.